personally, it's a must. We need this right now.
More people are stuck at home because of the pandemic, and calls for help from domestic violence victims, well, they're skyrocketing these days. Shelters operating at 50% capacity are filling up fast. WRTV6's Megan Sanctorum explains how some local organizations are now working together to help and why they're asking the community to step in as well.
It's a startling statistic from the Domestic Violence Network. Leaders there say there's been a 125% increase in calls for help since the pandemic started.
We are still sheltering in place, so you're with your abuser.
Kelly McBride with the DVN says those looking to leave an abusive situation are having a tough time finding somewhere to go as shelters fill up.
They are completely full and difficult to get into.
So now they're putting people in hotels, something survivors like Lucia Sheehan say can help save lives.
People living in those situations need those places to stay immediately to feel safe.
Sheehan now runs Violence Free Living, and she works with those involved in violent relationships by hosting programs in places like schools and jails. As a survivor who once had to make her own call for help, she knows how important it is for resources to be available right when you need them.
That type of an environment, when you're living with that, it takes a lot of strength. It takes a lot of courage to make that phone call. And if you don't get somebody to connect with right away, that could be it for them forever.
The Domestic Violence Network had about $35,000 in their hotel fund, thanks to donations from the Braveheart Foundation and Central Indiana Community Foundation. But McBride says that money is going fast, and they need community support.
It's great that these foundations have come through and they've seen the need and they provided us the funding. We are almost halfway through it and we've only been doing this for 2 weeks. So it's so important if we can have the community step up. Even $10, $20, it all adds up and it helps.
So far, the DVN has placed 8 adults, several children, and a puppy in safe housing with this money. They hope to be able to provide the same help and resources to everyone else who may need it. Working for you, Megan Sanctorum, WRTV6.
The Domestic Violence Network says 100% of donations will go to helping survivors. We have much more information on how you can donate, and that's at our website at theindychannel.com.